सुमित तो गए थे गाड़ी लेके, सुमित तो गाड़ी में गए थे,
हम
वो बोल रहे थे लेकिन गाड़ी लेके चला दी। अगर आपको तैयारी कर रहा है तो कीजिए, नहीं तो फिर बोला था चल 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 बात करते करते चलते हैं। आने का टाइम पे थोड़ा तैयारी लग रहा था, चलाते बहुत
हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू, कैन यू हियर मी?
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
ओके, नाउ टुडे वी विल जस्ट कंक्लूड दिस पार्ट, सरफेस एंड वॉल्यूम, एंड देन एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू आई विल टेक सम पॉज, आई विल गो बैक टू सम ओल्ड टॉपिक्स, प्रैक्टिस सम प्रॉब्लम, देन अगेन वी विल स्टार्ट आवर न्यू टॉपिक। And in between, if they declare the class test, then it will be better. आदर्श शर्मा कौन है भाई, लॉग इन किया हुआ है आदर्श शर्मा?
यस सर।
तो तुम्हारा प्रोफाइल में क्या विराट कोहली का प्रोफाइल क्यों है, तस्वीर?
ओके सर, आई विल चेंज इट।
और तुम फैन हो सकते हो उसका, हम भी फैन है, लेकिन प्रोफाइल में उसका पिक्चर दे रहा है, कंफ्यूजिंग।
ओके सर, आई विल चेंज।
आदर्श शर्मा तुमको पिक्चर लग रहा है विराट कोहली का, क्या ऐसे कैसे हो सकता?
ओके सर, आई विल चेंज इट।
सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। अच्छा, ये चीज तो ठीक से समझ गया था, ये जो सॉलिड और रिवॉल्यूशन अराउंड एनी लाइन इन द प्लेन, ये डिस्कस हुआ था उस दिन? वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस द सिचुएशन वेयर some curve is rotating about x axis or about y axis, this situation we have discussed, but now the situation can be generalized, the situation can be generalized that you can consider the revolution about any line. Now the thing is that the basic idea is same, again you have to consider all this right circular elementary cylinder, but the calculation technique might be slightly difficult or some slightly new. So have I discussed this thing in the last classes, or I should again discuss it?
Yes, sir.
Please response.
Yes, sir.
This has been discussed or not?
Yes, sir. Discussed.
Please explain once, sir. Sir, ek bar repeat kar dijiye.
Repeat, sir.
ठीक है कोई जल्दी नहीं तो रिपीट कर देते हैं, ठीक से समझो, ठीक से समझाने का कोशिश है, खत्म करना कोई
सर।
बड़ा बात नहीं है, ठीक से एक बार फिर करो। ओके देखते हैं कोई अगर घुर सके नहीं, ठीक है ठीक है। ओके हियर आई एम कंसीडरिंग, I will assume you remember all these previous formula, that is volume of revolution about x axis. What is the formula, Nisha? Can you tell me what is the formula for volume and surface area for rotation about x axis?
No idea, sir. I don't attend the first class.
You didn't attend?
No, sir.
Then, okay. Anyone else?
Sir, integration from x one to from x one to x two, pi y square dx from toward the x axis.
Pi.
Pi y square dx.
Pi y square dx. And for x axis, it will be pi x square dy, y1 to y2. Now, here I am taking the line AB as a general line. Any straight line, y is equal to mx plus c. Any straight line, AB. So this is our line. And now we are considering the rotation of this same LM curve. Y is equal to fx is its equation, LM curve, about this line. So this is rotating this way, okay? So this type of one spindle-like figure, okay? The spindle-like figure will be generated with this open face, L and M. These are the open faces, circular faces, obviously. So this will be a spindle-like figure. And it can change to anything depending on the curve, equation of the curve, LM. So again, we will use the same technique of adding all these elementary cylinder, right cylinder. So these are the PN and P dash 10 dash, okay? This would be P dash 10 dash, PN and P dash 10 dash, suppose. So N N dash is the small height of the cylinder. Now, the point you should note here that we cannot write N N dash as X dx. What we was doing, in the previous situation, it was being taken as dx or dy when the axis of rotation is x and y respectively. But here I cannot take it dx because AB is not the x-axis. Clear? Is it okay? AB is not the x-axis. So N N dash, this is the elementary height of the cylinder, okay, but this cannot be taken as dx. So we have to calculate N N dash. That is the main problem, a new thing, new mode of calculation in this GLI situation, okay? So our elementary cylinder volume will be, obviously, if I imagine this cylinder rotating at this PXY, okay? So this will produce, and since PN and P' is very close to each other, so I will take PN as the radius of the circular cylinder, and so the cylinder volume will be obviously pi pn square, this radius pn square into the height. So this is the height, small height, n n dust, okay, n n dust. So pi pn square n n dust is the volume of the cylinder thus generated, elementary cylinder. And adding this elementary cylinder from L to M, we will get the volume, okay? So our required formula will be V limit of pi pn square nn dust, where nn dust tending to zero, where nn dust will tend to zero. Now, that can be written as pi zero to AB. Okay. Pn square into D of an. So, in our x-axis, what we were doing, please try to just take the analogy of this thing. Take the problem here. So OM was, okay, better take this figure will be better here. So ON is X and NN dashed is DX, okay? ON is X, NN dashed is DX. So D of X. So I cannot write here D of X, but what I should write? What is the length here? Tell me. If I start from A, so A to N. suppose A is the starting point. I'm measuring this along this curve, along this straight line AB from A. So AN and this D of AN is the small NN dashed. This I will take as D of AN. Just by the analogy of what I did in case of x-axis rotation, x and d of x, okay? X, O to N is x, then N, N dash is dx. Similarly, it will be d of AN. So our formula will be pi PN square d of AN. And we will go from 0 to AB, okay? And similarly, the surface area will be 2 pi into PN. Into elementary arc PP dust, elementary arc PP dust. As we know, in the surface area, we cannot take this line because that will, NN dust is a part of the straight line, but PP dust is a part of the curve. So in order to calculate the surface area, we have to consider this curve. So I will take PP dust. So elementary length 2 pi into PN into elementary arc PP dust. So that is equal to DS. So 2 pi will be coming outside, integration PN DS. Integration PNDS. So these are the two formula, and let's see how this can be implemented in a particular situation. So suppose in this problem, AB is the straight line about which this AB, this circular arc AB, okay, which will produce 90 degree at the center. So this is a quadrant, okay? One fourth of the circle AB that is rotating about this AB point. That is rotating about this AB straight line, okay? In the AB straight line, this way it is rotating, okay? So P is any point on this circular arc AB, and PN is the perpendicular drop from P to this AB line. Now, first of all, angle AOP is equal to theta, this angle AOP is equal to theta, this P line. So what will be the minimum angle P will produce? P will traverse along this AB, P will traverse along this AB. When P will be merged with A, then what is the value of theta? Tell me, when P will be very close to A, what is the value of theta?
Zero,
almost zero. So starting point of theta will be zero. And as P will be traversing through A to B, when P will be very close to B, then what is the value of theta? What is the value of theta when P is very close to B?
90 degrees.
So our range of theta will be, if I can express the entire integral in terms of theta, then we know what is the range of theta, okay? The range of theta is 0 to pi by 2. So we will try to express this volume P, Pn square into dAn in terms of theta. So see how we are doing this thing. First of all, AP, this AP, AP is equal to 2A sine theta by 2. 2A sine theta by 2, okay? What is the proof of this thing? First of all, let us understand this thing. Okay. This OP, this is produced to this B. O is the center. So this PB, that will be the, okay, don't confuse with this B. This B is not I am considering. This is a new B. Okay. That's PO, this is produced to B. So this is our diameter, PB. This is our diameter. Okay. And POA, this is our angle theta. Again, check out with this problem. Okay, this PO is, forget about this B for the time being. This PO is produced to this B, okay, along the diameter. If I complete this circle, and if I produce this PO to PB, so suppose this is intersecting the parameter at B point. So PB will be the diameter. And what is the length of the diameter? That is a circle of radius A, so diameter will be twice A. Diameter will be twice A. Now consider this AP. This is a chord. This is a chord on this circle AB. Now this AP chord is producing theta angle here. So it will produce What is the angle it will produce at this point B here? Point B?
Theta by
theta. You can take this point. At this point B, what angle it will produce?
Theta by 2.
Half angle.
Theta by 2. Because always the any chord produce the angle theta at center and angle theta by 2 at perimeter. This is known. Now we consider the triangle PAB. We consider the triangle PAB. Okay. So now we use Lamy's theorem. In your properties of triangle, all of you know what is the Lamy's theorem. In any triangle ABC, we can write always A by sine A. Okay. A is the side length. A by sine A. Sine A is equal to is the angle. Capital is the angle opposite to the side A. So sides, as you know, the sides are denoted by small a, small b, small c. So A by sine A, sine capital A is the angle opposite to the side small a, is equal to B by sine B. B is small b by sine capital B. Sine capital B is the angle opposite to the side small b, and is equal to C by sine C. This is called Lamy's theorem. A by sine A is equal to B by sine B is equal to sine C by sine C. This is the basic results in properties of triangle. Now, if we use the same result here, so PB is the length and opposite angle is this. Now, what is the angle? This angle, total angle A. Anybody can say, what is the angle?
90 degree.
Why it is 90 degree?
Diameter, sir, who extend.
Because this is the diameter. So diameter is producing 180 degree angle at center. So half angle, that is 90 degree at perimeter. This is the general property of any circle. This is the angle at center will be twice the angle of perimeter. So a PAB will be 90 degree. So PB by opposite angle, sine of opposite angle, equal to AP by sine of opposite angle. What is that angle? Angle sine theta by 2. As we already discussed, this angle will be again sine theta by 2. Okay. So PB by sine pi by 2 is equal to AP by sine B, and AP is equal to PB sine B, and that is equal to PB is equal to twice A, and B is equal to theta by 2. So twice A sine theta by 2. Okay. So AP is equal to twice A sine theta by 2. Everybody is clear why AP is equal to twice A sine theta by 2?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then going back to our original problem. Okay, so AP is equal to twice A sine theta by 2, and PAN, that is this angle. What is that angle? PAN, this angle, that will be half of angle POB. Half of angle POB. Why? This angle will be half of this angle. Why? Anyone can say?
Again repeat, sir, which angle?
Huh?
Which angle, sir? Again repeat.
This POB, this angle will be twice of this angle. PAN or PAB, whatever it is, PAN or PAB. Why this is so?
So circumangle is half of centroid.
Again. So what is the chord here? What is the chord here?
AB.
Not AB.
AP.
AP.
PB.
Not AP. PB. It is the chord PB. It is not written here. PB. PB is the chord. Now PB is producing some angle 90 degree here and some angle here. PAB. At the same time. So see, this angle will be half of this angle, POB. That is why I am writing PN is equal to half of POB. Okay. Now POB, what is that? That is equal to 90 degree total. This is 90 degree total minus theta. So 90 degree pi by 2 minus theta. So this will be half of pi by 2 minus theta. Half of pi by 2 minus theta. That is pi by 4 minus theta by 2. So PN will be equal to twice A. Now see, what is PN? This one, PN. So perpendicular by hypotenuse, that is equal to sine of this PAN. That is sine of this pi by 4 minus theta. sine of pi by 4 minus theta. So Pn will be equal to AP sine pi by 4 minus theta. AP sine pi by 4 minus theta. What is AP? Twice a sine theta by 2. So Pn will be twice a sine theta by 2 sine pi by 4 minus theta by 2. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, it is AP sine of Pn. AP sine Pn. That is equal to twice a sine theta by 2 sine pi by 4 minus theta by 2. Okay, so we got an expression Pn in terms of theta. What I told you, our plan is to express this integral Pn square into dn. Okay, this Pn square into dn in terms of theta. Why? Because the range of theta we know. Range of theta we know. So we can integrate. So Pn is this and n equal to this. N, what is n? Again, tell me. So n is this. So base by AP, base by AP, base by hypotenuse, this cause of this angle. That means it will be AP cause of this. So AP, that is twice the sine theta by 2 into cause of pi by 4 minus theta by 2. This is an. So an will be equal to this. A of sine of pi by 4 plus sine of theta minus pi by 4. This is 2 sine a sine b, that is sine of a plus b, sine of a minus b. This is, and this is 2 sine a cos b, this is cause of minus b, and cause of a plus b is this. Okay, so these are very simple. This I've got this Pn and an in terms of theta. Now, our volume will be pi of Pn square dot d of an. So Pn square is this, cos of theta minus pi by 4 minus cos of pi by 4 whole square into this d of an. What is that? D of an, what is that? Tell me. D of an is d of this. Now this is constant, will be 0. So a will be constant outside. So d of this, that will be cos of theta minus pi by 4. Cos of theta minus pi by 4. Okay. D of an. So our integral is this. Cos a minus cos b into cos of theta minus pi by 4 d theta. This will be whole square. 0 to pi by 2. Into pi a cube. My purpose, a cube is coming. Very simple. Here one a cube, here in one a square, whole square, Pn square. Pn square is a square, and there is an will produce one a, so a cube, total a cube. So pi a cube is this. And the remaining part is very simple. That is a simple integral, putting cos pi by 4 is equal to root 2, and multiplying these things, cos cube pi minus theta by 4, minus root 2 cos square pi theta minus pi by 4, plus half of this. So just integrate this thing, three terms, and that will give you this result. Pi a cube, 10 minus 3 pi by 6 root 2. Okay. I will advise you rather to complete this integral by your own. That will increase your confidence. Okay. Everybody should calculate this integral by your own and check the result. And by the same way, s is equal to 2 pi sine a d theta. What is a d theta? Can anybody tell what is a d theta? That is equal to ds. That is equal to this part. Pp dashed, very small amount. What is that? Suppose this is theta. Okay, this is theta. Now, there is a very small change in, small increment in theta. This will be d theta. Okay, just consider this line. Consider this line. Okay, consider, follow my cursor. So this is our this p is changed to p dashed. Okay, so this will be d theta. So d theta will be this arc length p dash will be r d theta, because we know in case of circle s is equal to r theta. Arc length s is equal to r theta. So ds is equal to r d theta. That is p dash is equal to r d theta. So p dash is equal to r d theta. We will replace here. So we have this thing. I hope everybody is clear. This is your r d theta. Okay, that is r is equal to a in our case, so a d theta. So pn into 2 pi pn into a d theta, 0 to pi by 2. And that will also give you this result, pi square 4 minus pi by root 2. Everybody is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, next, there is two theorem of Pappas, or sometime it is called Guldin. So these theorems are sometime very useful to find the volume and surface revolution, but actually this theorem is not used for in general. They cannot be used because this has some problem. Let me describe the theorem, then you will understand yourself why this is not very useful theorem. The volume of the solid generated is equal to the product of the revolving area, product of the revolving area and the length of the arc described by the centroid of the area. Centroid by the area. So suppose a half circle is rotating. So half circle is rotating, the area of the half circle is pi r square. Product of the revolving area. So it is the pi r square. And length of the arc. Length of the arc described by the centroid of the area. So what will be the centroid of the half circle? So if I suppose, let me draw this thing, then you will understand. So they are saying that suppose half circle. Half circle, how can I find half circle here? No, it is not happening. Half circle. Okay, let me draw full circle, then I will understand this way. Suppose this half circle. This half circle is rotating, this half circle, okay? And also, this half circle is rotating, okay, around this x-axis. So what is the area of the half circle? If the radius is suppose A, the area will be pi square by 2. Pi square by 2 into the arc length of the perimeter described by the centroid of this half circle. So what is the centroid of this half circle? That is situated, that will be situated somewhere here. Okay. Most probably it will be A by 3. But this is the problem in this theorem. We have to know where the centroid will be. So if this is A by 3 here, so there will be one point where the center here, A by 3, and that will produce one perimeter of what length? 2 pi into A by 3, 2 pi r, 2 pi into A by 3. So you have to take the product of 2 pi into A by 3 into the area of the half circle, pi a square by 2. That will give you the total volume of the revoluting area, okay? Solid of revolution. This is the thing. Could you understand? First of all, you have to find the area of the revolving part. Okay, so this is a half circle, the area is this. And then you have to find the position of the centroid. That requires some new calculation, okay? To find the position, and suppose it is not a half circle, it's a irregular shape. Then you have to do a lot of calculation to find the position of the centroid. So again, you have to calculate the perimeter it is producing, the length of the perimeter when the center of centroid is again rotating about x-axis. When the centroid is rotating about x-axis. So this theorem is not very useful in general. In general, it is not very useful. That is why this is not much discussed among this area. So for the purpose of completion of the course, I'm discussing this thing. So these are the volume and also surface area can be generated in this way, but we will barely use this thing, okay? Rather, we will use the normal way of integration, that is pi x squared dy and this generalized situation, that will be better. So let us solve another problem. So the circle x squared plus y squared is equal to a square is revolving around x-axis. Find the surface area and volume of the whole surface generated. obviously the denominator will be a sphere. Now, x square plus y square plus square means y is equal to root over a square minus x square. I am taking only the positive part, not the negative part. So dy dx is equal to minus x of root over a square minus x square. And ds dx whole square is equal to 1 plus dy dx whole square. So ds will be equal to 1 plus dy dx whole square root under into dx. Okay. So that will be equal to square minus x square root under into dx. So required surface area will be 4 pi 1 plus dy dx whole square root under, that is y ds dx into dx, that is y ds, that is root over of square minus x square, that is y. And ds dx equal to root over of this, that is a by a square minus x square into dx. Okay. What is ds? Root under 1 plus dy dx whole square into dx. That is dx into root under this. Root under this is a by root over a square minus x square. And this y is equal to root under a square minus x square. So the thing will be a will be coming out 4 pi a and only dx 0 to a, that is 4 pi a square. So this is the surface area of a sphere, 4 pi a square. And what is the volume? 4 by 3 pi r cube. It should come. So 2 pi y square dx. Y square dx is a square minus x square dx. That will be equal to, again, by integrating 0 to a, 4 by 3 pi a cube. This is the volume. Okay. So I can calculate the volume and surface area of a sphere in this way also. Actually, this is a proof. We often use this formula, but we don't know how far from this is coming. So these are the proofs of this thing. Okay. The surface area is 4 pi a square and the volume is 4 by 3 pi r cube. Okay. Now tell me if you have any question on this and anything to ask. The material is clear to all?
Yes, sir.
Actually, problem should be practiced. So this is the main thing. Otherwise, you will forget. When I'm telling you, it will appear easy, but when you will go for solving this thing, it may be difficult. So our task will be to solve some problems. In the next class, actually, we will solve some problem. We will take some old topics. Actually, I will start from very beginning. Okay, very beginning means mean value theorem and other things. From the starting point, I will take some problem and I will solve this. Problems, okay, practice. All of you will practice these problems. So I think before class test, it will not be very wise to go for completing other modules also, because we are not in hurry. So better it will be to practice more problems on the same topic so that your class test, you can give it comfortably, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
When will you take the class?
Yes, sir.
I don't know. Actually, this will be centrally declared. I cannot declare it by myself. Okay. This will be centrally declared by principal, but I hope it will be declared for at the last of January or in the first week of February. I hope it will be scheduled at that period. Okay. So better we should practice and we'll keep ourselves ready for class test. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, everybody solve this problem though, and tell me the answer. This one, evaluate 0 to 4 pi cos mod cos x dx. Mod cos x dx 0 to 4 pi. Everybody solve it and tell me the result. Everybody chat. In the chat, you write the result. Can you solve its result? Solve this problem, anyone? Zero to four pi mod cos x dx. Shubham?
Yes, sir.
Can you solve this problem? Zero to four
pi
mod cos x dx. Trying. Trying. Okay. Try.
Yes, sir.
And give me the answer in chat. Nisha? Nisha?
Yes, sir.
Solving? Trying?
Yes, sir.
Okay, everybody try. Everybody try. Okay. Wasim? Wasim Ahmed?
Yes, sir.
You are trying?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Good. Give me the problem in the chat. I'm just waiting for 5 minutes. All of you. Joy has telling 8. Minus 8 of, why you have given this tilde sign, Joy? Tilde sign?
Sir.
It is only 8 or whatever it is, only 8?
Yes, sir. 8.
Okay, 8. Okay, your answer is 8. Anyone else? You have to take care of the change of sign as x is going from 0 to 4 pi. And do accordingly. And you know, I have already several times I have told you that mod x equal to x when x is greater than 0, mod x equal to minus x when x is less than 0. This thing you should keep in your mind. And accordingly, you have to split.
So please, so once the question.
This is the question. Evaluate 0 to 4 pi mod cos x dx. Almol Kumar is telling 8. Okay. Almol Gupta.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Only two. What the others are doing? Nisha, 8. Okay, everybody is getting it 8. So this will be 8. Why? Because this within 0 to 4 pi, this periodic function with pi, hence the given integral will be 4 to 0 to pi using property 8. Okay, because this is a even function. Mod of cos x always an even function and periodic function with respect to pi, since it is a mod x. In general, remember, mod x is not in general a periodic function with period pi. It is a periodic function with period 2 pi, cos x. Cos x is a periodic function with period 2 pi. but mod cos x will be a period function because all the negative values will be pd. So negative humps, all the negative humps will be positive humps. So the period will reduce. Period will be pi. So cos x has a period pi. So if x, if we know what is the formula, 0 to n a f x dx, 0 to n a f x dx, that will be n 0 to a f x dx. If f x is equal to f x plus t, f x plus pi. So this is exactly happening here. Mod of x plus pi is equal to x mod of x cos x. So we can write this thing then. 4 of 0 to 4 pi is equal to 4 of 0 to pi. Since f of x, that is mod of cos x, that is equal to mod of cos x plus pi. Same. So I will do these things. Or you can break it. All sine, you know the signs. All sine tan cos. From 0 to pi by 2, all, then sine. Pi by 2 to pi, it will be minus. Then my pi by 2, pi to 3 pi by 2, it will be again minus. Then again 3 pi by 2 to pi, it will be plus. All sine tan cos, it will be plus. So accordingly, you can break it. Okay? From 0 to 4 pi, you can, this way you can also break it. That way you can also do. Okay? Okay.
Sir? Can we solve this problem by the interval breaking?
I was telling. I can solve this problem by interval breaking also.
Yes, sir.
If you don't remember this part, you should remember all this property of definite integral. Okay? F of x plus a is equal to fx. If this is true, then 0 to na fx dx is equal to n 0 to a fx dx. It's simple. Okay? Okay, now solve this property, this problem. X by 1 plus sec x, 0 to pi by 3. X by 1 plus sec x dx, 0 to pi by 3. First of all, you should try to get rid of this one in the denominator, 1 plus sec x. You should get rid of this. That will be your first choice. First calculation technique, trick. So get rid of this one. How that can be done?
Sir, convert sec into cos.
You can write sec by cos. So cos x plus 1, that you can write. What is the cos x? Cos 2x is equal to 2 cos square x minus 1. So cos x will be 2 cos square x by 2 minus 1. So the denominator will be 2 cos square x by 2. And the numerator will be x cos x. X cos x. Then you can proceed.
So if the answer is 2 pi by 3 root 3?
Let me check it. Answer is this, pi square by 18 minus pi by 3 root 3 plus 2 log 2 by root 3. Pi square by 18 minus pi by 3 root 3 plus 2 log 2 by root 3. So you are making some mistake in integration, I think. See what they have done. 2 cos square x by 2 and this I have written 2 cos square x by 2 minus 1. Then this will be again x into 1 minus half sec square x by 2. They are written this way. So they will just go for a by parts. We'll go for a by parts. because actually 6 square, I know that, what is that? 10. 10 difference is not 10 is 6 square. So I can take help of that. So that will be x dx minus half of this x, x square x. And this is simple integration x dx and x, x square. I can write this thing. Taking x as a first function, different integration of x square is this, 10x by 2 by half. And then minus this, differentiation of x is 1, integration of 10x by 2, it will be this log of this. Okay? So ultimately, this thing will come. Okay, in the next class, today we will conclude here. So in the next class, you should be prepared with the first part of that is evolute, involute. And what was that? With that mean value theorem. Evolute, involute, and mean value theorem. This part you practice. Whatever material you have, whatever study material you have, or class notes, whatever I've given you, or book, you practice all those things. Then I will give you some problem or I will take just like a class test type of thing. I can take a class test, small class test, okay? So that you have a practice. So in the next class, I will start from the very beginning. Then mean value theorem and evolute, involute, I will again discuss. Say curvature, circle of curvature, center of curvature, these things will be discussed, okay? Not the theory, but only the problem. Theory I have already done, so you should go through that theory and again brush it up. Then I will solve some problem. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Then sir. Give your attendance and leave.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Keep in your mind. In the next class, we will recap from the very beginning. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Bye. Bye, everyone. Okay.
Bye, sir.
Bye, sir.
Junaid Ansari.
Yes.
Why are you giving here in the chat? You are writing your roll number. No need. You have to give your attendance only in the Google form. All these things will not be recorded. Okay. No recording will be done. This
okay.
Nikunj Ranjan, Tajuddin. Don't give your roll number in the chat. This is useless. Roll number, you should only take the Google form link. I've already given you, all of you know. Okay, recording. That will be recorded.